I know I don't look it, but I have a daughter who graduated from college. And she had been there for 4 years, and I had to find a vehicle large enough to bring back all of her education. So I had rented from U-Haul, but I never really had seriously considered renting a truck this large before. And I should have known what I was in for when I walked in through the yard. Have you ever been into the yard where they store all the U-Haul stuff? There are these trucks there, and they all say, U-Haul, which should communicate something right away as to where the responsibility is going to lie here. And immediately underneath it says, Adventure in Moving. You don't really grasp the significance of that until you turn the truck in later. But anyway, I go in and I am mystified. I mean, they have more stuff for rent at U-Haul. I always thought all they rented was like trailers and trucks. My gosh, there's garden hoses and there's boxes and there's little old ladies with wheelbarrows and they even have, you know, fountains in there with fish that you can rent for parties. And so I stepped up to the counter, you know, in this kind of eclectic atmosphere, and I said, I'd like to rent a truck. And he says, do you ever drive one of these things before? And I said, I drove a motorhome. And he went, oh. See, what I didn't tell him is that the motorhome had park, drive, 1 and 2 on it. And what he didn't tell me was that the 24-foot truck had a 200-pound test clutch and a big steel rod that came up out of the floor with no numbers on it. But we went through the whole thing, and I signed it, and I show him the driver's license. You know, he says, you want to take a look at the rig? Well, I figure I got to look at the rig. I want to get out there and take a look at it. And I go out, and I walk around. He says, that's your loading ramp? Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know loading ramps, yeah. He says, well, I guess you're ready to go, then it's all gassed up. And, yeah, okay, all right, thanks. So I climb up into the cab, and I'm sitting there, and my legs are hanging over the front seat like I'm in daddy's car, you know? And I look out the side, and there's 2 or 3 guys come out of the office now. They're all leaning against the wall like this. I got the baseball hats turned sideways, and, you know. By now, I'm up to about 20 miles an hour. I feel like I could tear the engine out of it. Well, anyway, the turnpike's pretty close by. And I'm on it, and I'm up to 65 and no sweat, you know. And it's really noisy. But not so noisy, I don't notice these little tiny toy cars going by me. These little Hyundas and Toyotas and Hondas. I feel like I could open the door and go, you know. But I don't. I restrain myself. I'm a responsible trucker. Right, and I blink my headlights a couple of times at oncoming trucks, you know, trying to get into the spirit of it. They don't blink back. And I look down and I see a place that could have had a CB radio, but I didn't think to rent one of those. I'm wondering what else I have to rent. And then I look over and I see an AM radio. I reach over and I got a 6-hour trip in front of me. Boy, I'm looking forward to spending some time with this radio. Oh, well, only 5 hours and 59 minutes to go. Well, I can only go along so far, you know, with the usual kind of way that you spend time, like, oh, there's an A, and there's a B, and there's a C. 99 bottles of beer on the wall, 99 bottles of beer. And then I see it.
Do you know how long a windshield wiper is in a truck? Remember, you know, the window is about this tall. It's about 2.5 feet long. Well, it's not raining, but I'm a sound effects freak, you know, and I think, I wonder what that's going to sound like. So I turn off. Sure enough, it's an industrial strength wiper blade, and you get this. And I, hey, that's got a nice catchy beat, you know. I'll just kind of leave it like that. And then I look down, and I see the hazard lights, and I pull them out, and sure enough, then I figure, hey, I wonder if I can get some tonality out of the radio. And I was starting to go, talking rappers, and when I go, I drive down the highway, this I know. And then it begins to dawn on me. I'm having a lot of fun, and I haven't noticed, but really, there hasn't been a single car past me in about 10 minutes. And I look in the rearview mirror, and there are all these little cars in the back. I'm not going to pass him. You're going to pass him. He's got his wiper blades on and a hazard light. So I started to get self-conscious, you know. And just as I'm about to pull over to the side anyway, a big 18-wheeler goes by. And the top of the truck goes like this. And he motions for me to pull over to the side. I am so excited. Because even though I don't have a CB, there's going to be some trucker talk going on here, you know. So I practice downshifting. And I pull down over to the side. He's out of his cabin, halfway back to me before I even come to a stop. And he says, hey, he said, did you know your loading ramp's falling out the back and was swinging out all over the highway? Adventures in moving.